Okay, so we do have something. Hotbabe.png. I was expecting a pig. I thought it was going to be a troll of a pig, but it's actually a girl. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Let's catch a rabbit. My name's Ash, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and we are back in form on Try Hack Me today. And we are tackling the room Year of the Rabbit. For notes, links, or timestamps, see the description down below. Otherwise, let's get into it. All right, here we go. We're on the room Year of the Rabbit. Time to enter the warren. Is this like a type of rabbit? I don't know what this is. So if we scroll down, we've got one task. So let's start up our machine. We're looking for our user flag and our root flag, and there's not much here besides let's have a nice gentle start to the year. Can you hack into the Year of the Rabbit box without falling down a hole? Please ensure your volume is turned up. All right, so that's a little bit different. Just have to quickly update the system. Honestly, it's been a little bit since I've been doing Try Hack Me, so my Linux box is a little out of date. Okay, updates are done, so let's get on the network. Sweet, so that worked. I can ping the box IP. Let's go ahead and start with our Rust scan. So like usual, we've got SSH, FTP? Yeah, FTP and HTTP. Okay, so now we know the ports. Let's run through that with a little bit more detail from Nmap. While Rust scan is doing its thing, let's go over and see that port 80. So we have our default page here. No hidden clues jumping out at me in the source. Nothing too exciting from the Nmap results. I'm gonna go ahead and try FTP login using anonymous. So FTP anonymous. Password blank, login incorrect, login failed. All right, no go. So we're probably looking for something to get in there. Let's go ahead and use Ferox Buster using our web content word list here and see if we can find anything. All right, so we picked up assets pretty fast. Let's go look at that. So we have a Rickrolled MP4. Do I even need to click on it? It's exactly what it said it is. Yeah, cool. We'll leave that there. We'll go check out the styles.css. Ooh, and we've got nice to see someone checking the style sheets. Take a look at this page. Super secret flag.php. Now there's no way that our word list would have that on there, so we wouldn't pick up on it. So we've navigated over to this, and that has also redirected us. That's so mean. So our Ferox Buster scan hasn't found anything else, so we'll just sort of leave it there, and maybe let's go try another tool. So I've got Burp Suite opened up here. Let's go target, we'll open up our browser. Let's paste in our IP that we're going to suss out. I'm gonna go proxy and look at the HTTP history, and we'll see this request that we've just sent in here. So still not really sure what I'm looking for. Something out of the ordinary, I suppose. Let's go control R and send this to the repeater and see if we can just play around. So there's nothing jumping out, but I sort of have the idea this page that it was directing us to that had the redirect, it does have something on it. Like there's something got to be there. If we navigate it to it in our Burp proxy browser, I can see it here in our history. In here, in the response, we actually do have something. It's probably a bit small on screen, but it says here we've got a hidden directory is equal to this. Ooh. So if we go back, not using our normal browser. Okay, so we do have something. Hotbabe.png. I was expecting a pig. I thought it was going to be a troll of a pig, but it's actually a girl. All right, I'm going to click this and I'll go copy link. So we'll go wget and grab our hotbabe PNG. All right, so we've got our PNG here. Apparently it is a PNG. I've already opened it up and it is an image, but there might be something else fishy here. Let's use EXIF tool, see if we can find any more information. Got our file size. It's confirming it's definitely a PNG, though nothing too out of the ordinary here. Let's switch over to Binwalk. It says that something's compressed, but the more I see this, the more I'm convinced that this is just a thing in PNGs. I'm not really sure. Let's use Binwalk anyway to extract what might be something hidden in here. Okay, so this extracted thing is just data. I don't know what that means. So if I try and cat it out, it's just nonsense. So I can't do anything with it. What about if I just run strings against it? Should start with strings. Okay. After just using strings, we've got something here. You've earned this. Username FTP is FTP username. One of these is the password. Okay. So we have a list here. So we're going to have to brute force into it. Cool. So make a note, FTP user, and let's make a list of passwords and go ahead and paste this in. So 82 possible passwords in here, 13 characters long. Shouldn't be too difficult to crack. So for cracking into a FTP, we can go ahead and use Hydra. They will specify the login with a dash lowercase l FTP user. And for the password list, it's an uppercase P, and we'll pass through that file that we just created. Then the other thing we need is the IP and to specify the protocol FTP. And I think that's everything that we need. Let's go. All right, that didn't take any time at all. One of the passwords did indeed match up. Let's go give that a copy. So we'll go back to our FTP. This time we'll use FTP user and paste in our password. We're in our remote directory, wherever that is in the system. And if we list out, we've got Eli's creds. Eli, so that's maybe the user that we actually need to log in over SSH. I'm just gonna go get everything. Failed to open file. How about I get this file, please? Command successful. Great. All right, let's get out of there. Okay, so we've got this file now. Let's go ahead and cat it out. And that is some cryptic looking nonsense. But I have actually seen this before. This is something with a title that's not very nice to say out loud. However, you may have come across this before in other CTFs. If you haven't, it looks like total just nonsense. And I guess the name is pretty appropriate. So I have actually learned in the past of how to read this or compile it. And we can use Beef. If you don't have Beef installed, you can go ahead and sudo apt that. But it is an interpreter for this programming language. Yeah, so all we need to do is run that through Beef, and there you go. There's our username and password. So given that SSH is the only other protocol, this is essentially leading us towards SSH. So let's SSH as our user over our IP. So we paste our password and we're in. But we get a message as we enter. Message from root to Gwendolyn. So a possible another user. Gwendolyn, I'm not happy with you. Our leet secret hiding place. I've left you a hidden message there. So we're looking for some leet secret hiding place. Let's start off by LSing where we're at. I've got core, I don't know what that is. Let's list out everything. It doesn't look like there's anything inside these files, these directories rather. What the hell is this core thing? It's some sort of executable. That's a bit sus. I don't know what that is. Can I execute it? I don't have permissions. I can read and write to it though, but I can't execute it. I don't know what this is. Let's just start off by looking at our Etsy password. So we have the FTP user that we FTP'd in. We have Gwendolyn. So there is using bin bash. We have us who we are logged in as. So we still need to find our user.txt file. So we're in our current directory. Do we see anything? Okay, so there's the user.txt that we're after. Do we have permissions? Damn. Okay, we can't look at this. So Gwendolyn has read access. So we need to transition users. It's not privilege escalation. We're like horizontally navigating our way. What's the technical term for this? So the only clue that we have is check our leet secret hiding place. Can we search for this secret hiding place? What if we find in the root directory something with the name of secret in leet speak? And we took our standard error, we output that to dev null. We've got user/games. Let's head over there. And here we go, a hidden file that root and everyone. This message is for Gwendolyn only. Yeah, right. Okay, we've got your password is awful, Gwendolyn. Should be at least 60 characters long, not just this. Let's go. Yours sincerely, root. All right, let's switch users over to Gwendolyn. Paste our password in. All right, sweet. Switched users. Now we can go check out that user.txt. Let's go change directories back to our home. Okay. Here we go. There is our first flag. Slap that into try hack me. Okay, so now what can we do? Paste password. Crap, what was that password? Make sure to take notes, kids, because forgetting. Wait, sudo dash L? Is that what I'm trying to do? All right, here we go. So yeah, we're trying to figure out how to escalate our privileges, and we have a command that we can run as root, which is using VI, the text editor, we can look at. So let's paste that in, and there is a way, since this is running as root, there's a way to escalate our privileges. And since I can't remember exactly how to do it, Let's go over to GTFO bins and let's look up VI. And there is shell. Is it shell that I want? I think it's this. I think we do this. I think we can run set shell bin bash and then we can execute shell. It's this one. Set shell equals bin sh and then I didn't run it with sudo. So I wasn't actually executing a sudo. I was executing as Gwendolyn. How do I get out of VI? Q. I don't know if you can hear the rain right now, but it's like bucketing down. All right, let's quickly redo this, but this time running sudo password for Gwendolyn, which I have pasted down. Sorry, user Gwendolyn is not allowed to execute this as root. I thought I could, man. Give me a sec to troubleshoot this. Okay, after a little bit of research, we need to go sudo dash u hashtag native one. And then paste in the command that we're trying to run. Then we can escalate our shell, and now we're root. If you're interested in more about what is vulnerable there, I'm gonna leave a link to an article that goes over it in much better detail than I can give here. So yeah, check that out if you're interested. But for us, it's pretty simple. Now we just cd back home into root rather, and there we have our root.txt. Give that a copy, paste that into Try Hack Me, and there we go. That's Year of the Rabbit. Hope you enjoyed this room. Thanks so much for watching all the way till the end. If you want to do all that YouTube stuff, feel free to. Up on the screen, you're going to see a recommended video going over an open source intelligent challenge that I've been given access to. I actually forgot to mention that you get a 15% off discount if you go watch that video and sign up using the code in the description. So definitely check that out if you're interested. Otherwise, yeah, thanks guys. I'll see you in the next video.